Good evening and welcome to the Health and Wellness Show here on COARadio.com. I'm so excited to be here. We have in-studio guests, some fun. And with me tonight is our very own musical director, Rich Chlanda. Welcome.
Hey, thank you. Okay, I forgot to put my headphones on before, so now I'm just getting... Wow, this sounds good, Art. Okay, good, I'm good. Hey, Maryann, what's up?
Everything's good. How about you?
I'm good.
And then, just what you said, because you introduced him yourself, our very own engineer that makes it all run every month. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Art Ackerman. So, Art, as you know, our very own Rich Chlanda here and Flying Dreams had one of their best shows, I think, ever at the Cutting Room.
Allegedly. It was a good show.
It was a fantastic show. You came out and did all new songs from your brand new album. It was fantastic.
Yep. Yes.
And then you had a special guest, Richard Howell, who was just on a horn section. I got to tell you, it was unbelievable.
Yep, he's a guy from San Francisco that really, he really surprised us. He was great.
He did.
He fit right in. So we just met him that day, but he really rocks. So thanks, Richard. Wherever you are.
Yes, and a shout out to Steve Walters in the Cutting Room, because I have to tell you, Gerard, who did the sound that evening, was amazing. And the light show that they did with that show was absolutely incredible.
I didn't expect that. You know, Mark, did they have lights there all the time? Because they had a great light show for us.
There was lights there last time, but the sound guy just turned everything on and kind of walked away.
Man, they had a fantastic light show this time. They were like...
Shows here. I've never seen lights.
Second song, I looked down and something was smoking. I didn't know it was a smoke machine. I said, okay, something caught on fire, you know. It was a smoke machine and there was lights all over the place and it was great.
And for those listeners that can't see in the studio, Rich, Mark Biner is standing behind me in our studio audience. That's who he's talking to.
Yeah.
You forgot about that.
I thought it was your alter ego.
Oh, when, yeah.
No, he's here. Mark Biner.
He's
Biner
behind me.
Biner.
And I can't see him, so I'm sure during the show I'll have fingers coming up over my head or doing something crazy.
And he can see it on the monitor.
I know. I have to put my trust in him now, right? Absolutely. But Richie had a fantastic show.
Thank you, yeah.
And you also have a couple announcements.
I do?
Yeah, you do, because for our listeners who might not have listened to the last show, is that Richie is now back with the legendary rock band Nectar.
Yes. Well, thank you for saying that. Yeah. Well, these guys, I was with them in 1978, and then Roy came back and
You're
I went
dating yourself.
Oh, well, it's okay. You got to date somebody. You know, so in any case, so I'm back with them. It's their 50th anniversary. They have a new record coming out that we'll do together and writing all new songs and, of course, playing the old favorites. And it's going to be a big thing. So I don't want to talk too much about it and give it away. But the light guy who did Pink Floyd and did other things, Mick Brockett, has a Mick Brockett light experience where he does it with real oils and stuff, with the exploding oils, just like the old...
It's the old school,
The old school stuff, you know, like at the Fillmore and all. So he was part of that crowd. So he's doing that. It looks great. The band sounds great.
It's good to know you can still buy those projectors.
Yeah, well, he does it by hand. He comes to rehearsal. He's all full of ink. But he does... It's really a real show with the real exploding ink and stuff like that. So it's crazy. And thanks, Maryann. Well, it's going to be a great experience for me. It's going to go all over the world.
I know. And I hope I could fit in that suitcase.
I think you will. And we'll see if we can get you.
I offer a lot of services.
Well, you do. You do. You help the band a lot. You know, don't forget, you know. So, yeah, we have to find rehearsal, too, you know, and get down the stairs and stuff.
We'll be getting back to hell. What is it?
Wealth and hellness.
Wealth and hellness.
Yes.
A girl makes one mistake. But before I get to that mistake, I want to get to our very special guest this evening. Without further ado, our guest tonight is a fitness professional for over 30 years. She is a certified personal trainer, an Optavia coach, a life coach, CPR instructor, consultant, and a professional speaker. She will delve into life coaching, fitness, and different types of wellness throughout the show. She is the person who helps you be the best version of you. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the show Kathy Margiasso.
Hello.
Welcome.
Thank you for having me. Thank you so much.
I'm happy to have you here. I think we can learn a lot from you. But please be in, like, bear in mind, we have Rich and Art in the room. So anything you and I talk about regards to health or fitness, just know we're probably in for it. I got that funny feeling.
We're going to catch on fire.
It's very good.
Just know we probably won't be practicing it.
Well, that's the part that's going to scare me. But you know what's nice? She came here all lovely, dressed in a beautiful dress and all. So I don't think you have to worry about any kind of workout or anything that she's going to do.
This is a good thing.
Especially because I see a box of munchkins in front of Rich, as always. Well, and we have water.
That's right. Well, I have water, too.
That's right.
So
I need to get the munchkins back.
No, I'll give them back to you, but I found the M&Ms in the drawer, too.
I
hit them up, too. Okay. I hit them up pretty bad.
Is that all we left in there?
Yeah.
That's all I saw.
That's all that I saw. But, yeah, so enjoy those munchkins.
Okay, thank you.
Because you'll hear him chomping on them on the air, just so you know. Like I said.
That's okay.
So get used to it. But before we even get to the interview, I am so excited because of talking to you. We have a new sponsor on the show this evening. And I have to talk about it at the top of the hour because if you call in during the show, just randomly, you might just win this as well. But our new sponsor is the high-tech glowing sports headphones, and they are the high-tech glow buds is what they call them. They illuminate for over 4 hours with continuous use on a single charge. And the athletic over-the-ear design offers snug and secure placement for long-lasting comfort while you're on the move. And it's great for jogging, for biking, for any other physical activity. These things are amazing. They took them out and showed them to us just before the show.
That's great.
You're not wearing a pair now?
I can't. I already have a monitor in. But these things, they have key features. They are for safety. So when you wear glow buds at night while walking, jogging, or biking, it makes you more visible to surrounding traffic. It keeps children visible when playing in the evening hours. And it has electroluminescent technology. Woo! That's something I got out. Wow. I'm so happy I did.
That's a big word.
It glows while remaining cool to the touch. Its low energy consumption allows you to get the most of one charge. And it has two glowing modes. This is what fascinated me. You can pulse to the beat of your music or always on for continuous enhanced visibility. Me, I'd be pulsing because I just like blinking lights. Yeah. So I think that's really cool. And to top it off, it has hands-free calling. A built-in mic and inline answer and button allow you to interrupt your music to take a call. And there's a sound battery bypass. So glow buds do not need to be charged in order to use them as regular headphones. The built-in lithium battery is only used to illuminate the cable. So that's a plus. You could use them right away. You don't have to wait for a charge. And high-performance drivers produce clear, crisp, studio-quality sound. Built-in rechargeable lithium battery never needs replacement. That's what I said. The lithium battery never needs replacement. Wow. There is a play, pause, track control, and you can answer and end calls as well. It has a micro USB charging port, 3 included cushions, which of course any size, small, medium, or large, ensure a perfect fit for virtually all ear sizes. And it's compatible with iPhone, iPod, iPads, Samsung, and other Android devices. So get your high-tech glowing sports headphones, your Glow Buds. And thank you so much for being a sponsor on the Health and Wellness Show here on COARadio.com. I had to get that out because I just love these things.
Yeah.
And since you're into fitness, this is perfect.
It is.
That's great.
It is.
I was going to say, not the thing to wear if you're like going to murder somebody.
Got it.
Well, it depends what song you're playing and
that's
how you.
That's true. That's true.
Wow.
Well, I'm just saying with all the glow features, and you know, give away your location.
Well, possibly. I think so. But since, see, they're going to already start. I already warned you of this because I knew it was going to happen. So I'm getting to our special guest because she's been sitting here so patiently.
Okay.
Is that
I'm
good?
Yeah, of course. We're good. We're just rocking with you.
Just wait for it. That's what I'm going to tell you, Kathy. Wait for it. Okay. And tonight, by the way, just one more time, before, if you want to call into the show and speak with our special guest live, you can do that at 609-241-7103. So, Kathy, before we get into the fitness, the life coaching, I'd like to talk about you. Mm-hmm. So you studied radiation therapy technology at the Memorial Sloan Kettering School of Radiation and became a staff therapist. What made you choose radiation therapy? It's something I don't see every day, so I'm curious.
Okay. As a student in high school, I was very much into math and science and anatomy and the body. And I literally, by accident, got turned on to the industry by a neighbor that was already a radiation therapist at Memorial Sloan Kettering. And I grew up in Forest Hills, Queens.
Oh, okay.
And basically, they were like, you know, there's this program, and we're always looking for new students that are really into math and science. And that's what I did. I went straight from high school into the program in 1980. See, I'm dating myself too. and it was a 2-year program, and you know, Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. You know, all our clinicals and everything, and they hired me as a staff therapist once I had graduated.
All right. So it was worth it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, I have a question for you, because mm-hmm. sometimes there's controversy on this. So I'm just asking, mm-hmm. in your opinion, is radiation therapy for everyone?
Oh, in my opinion?
Yeah, in your opinion. I'm strictly asking your opinion.
Okay. you know, cancer research has changed dramatically over the years, and so with now all types of immunotherapy and gene testing and everything, people that we treated 30 years ago when I was in the industry that we knew didn't have a good prognosis, now they're having wonderful, you know, prognosis. So, and that comes from all, like I said, great chemotherapy is drugs. Yes, radiation still has a purpose for palliative treatment and in, you know, for certain protocols for cure. So there's still a definite need for, you know, educated, caring people to be in the industry, yes.
Okay, that was a good answer. Actually, I think it was really well thought out, too.
That was
a great answer. So then this is where I need to figure this out. Mm-hmm. So you're in radiation therapy. So then you decide to become a personal trainer and a group exercise instructor.
Yes.
So why the switch? Because that's a really drastic switch.
It's a big change. Correct. You know, so I'm a radiation therapist. I was very young, obviously 20, 21 years old. And I started exercising just for my health. I was a kind of a heavy teenager. Mm-hmm. And back then, somebody had looked at me, and of course, what, in your 20s, you look good, right? So, and I had danced as a kid, and I had rhythm, and I was taking a class, and somebody said to me, you know, you could teach this class, I'm leaving. And I go, okay. and that's literally how I started. And there were no certifications at the time. I taught the class, and that was it. So it became something I did on the side. Mm-hmm. So something I did in the evenings, the weekends, around my full-time job, before I had children, actually.
Wow. Okay.
And it was something that I just truly enjoyed. I'm a people person. I love being, whether it be on the side of helping people that are ill, or helping people, you know, preventively stay away from illness as best that they can. Can't do anything about genes, but there's lifestyle choices that we
right.
can make, right? And basically, that's really how it started. I took one of the first certifications that were out there, was the International Dance Exercise. I think a lot of fitness professionals don't want to know that. And then from there, it just started to roll into personal training, and I started layering my certifications. In 1999, I decided to make the full switch from I became inactive in that industry, and decided to do full-time health and wellness to be a personal trainer. And again, I've done a lot of things in the industry. I think I've held every position within health and wellness other than ownership. So I've been the group exercise director, I've been the fitness director, and my recent job was as a general manager of a women's only boutique studio. And my whole career has been in Westchester County. I've studied fascia, I mean, you know, connective tissue. Depending on what stage in life I was at, was kind of what I created. So in other words, when I, at one health and health club that I worked, one of my first big fitness jobs, I created their cancer well-fit program. Mm. So how people can stay healthy while they're on treatment, afterwards to stay proactive,
right.
You know, because it's such an interesting dynamic when somebody is having cancer treatment. They, you know, they can't wait till it ends. They right. can't wait till the treatment ends. And then all of a sudden, those last couple weeks, they go, oh my God, like, what am I doing, like, proactively to stay well?
Mm-hmm.
And literally, I used to tell them, you know, you have almost three different lives. You have your life as you know it before your diagnosis. You live the treatment. It's, right. Sometimes it could be a long time, depending on if they have radiation, chemotherapy, or whatever, surgery. And then you have to learn how to be a survivor, mm-hmm. and how to be proactive. So in staying well. And that, so I created that program. When I started having children, I did the prenatal program. When I had kids, it was stroller size. When I had, you know, then it was postpartum. So it was.
So you were making your lifestyle changes.
Correct.
And then incorporating them into the programs of where you were doing these.
From the beginning.
There you go.
Yes.
From the beginning. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
And then that gave you a chance to help others while you were making your own lifestyle changes, mm-hmm. in the progress. That's amazing. And now, so I have to ask this.
Mm-hmm.
So back when you're saying in your 20s and the dance moves, like, was it with the headband?
Oh, of course.
And like the physical, let's get physical.
Oh, absolutely.
I have a secret then. Are
okay,
you ready?
Okay.
I'm going to let the cat out of the bag right here. Look, he's getting up because he knows it's about him.
Do you know that
our very own Rich Chlanda used to write all the music for the Denise Austin aerobic tapes?
No.
Look at the face. he wants to kill me right now.
There's no face. Yes.
And who else? You've done.
I did a bunch of people. You know, I did. There used to be a girl on TV, Joni Greggins. I did.
Oh, sure.
Every Sunday.
Yeah. And Denise Austin's still around.
And Denise Austin.
Did you do the yoga ones?
I did the yoga ones. I did. But I used to work for. Parade Video, then he used to work for Suncoast and Scimitar. They were all the distributors, and they hired me to write. You know, what they used for songwriting, they used to say, here's a cassette of 10 songs. Write, mm-hmm. 10 songs that sound like these, mm-hmm. you know? You know, and I did.
Yeah, mm-hmm. but then he's got this huge plaque. It's huge, and it has every single...
We sold millions.
They sold millions.
Really,
it was the whole sales presentation about
it. It was a big thing, you know? I mean, I didn't make millions. It was all work for hire in those days, but I did that.
I have a bunch of those VHS tapes.
Well, that's what they all are.
No, I mean...
And there's the secret.
Yeah, no.
Oh, see, somebody might have heard that.
Oh.
And we have our first caller on... The Health and Wellness Show. I'm your host, Maryann Castello, and you are live on the air. Who is this?
Hey, it's George making his appearance. I'm back from the dead.
Wow, I haven't heard from you, George, in a
very
long time.
I know. I was taking a little break, but now I'm back. I figured I'd warm up on Robbie and Maryann first. And then I'm going to hit that call one up again real soon.
He's still messing up all our names. I love it. George hasn't changed.
You know, Coleman is going to get it. So I hope he's listening tonight because this is my little warning to him. The 10-year anniversary show, let me tell you something. It's all going down. Not sending me my prize.
You are funny, George. And you're calling Health and Wellness. So how are you doing with your health and wellness?
He's gone.
Oh, no.
He does that.
Oh, no.
George is fantastic for that. He really is. George, Danny Coleman has a show here on COARadio.com called Rock On Radio. And George just started calling one time and kept calling. And then we didn't hear from him for a while. So I guess he's made his return.
That felt good to hear.
Wow.
All right.
It makes everybody stunned. But thank you, George, for reaching out. At least I know you're still around. Everything is still good with you. So getting back to Kathy here, as you know, now that you got the whole thing, the let's get physical thing,
uh-huh.
there you go.
I was young and needed the money. That's what that was.
No, now he's old and he needs the money.
Now, there's some things, because you said that as you did lifestyle changes, you were changing whatever exercise, mm-hmm. you were doing. So you had, from my understanding, the MELT method. What is that?
Yes, I studied the MELT method. It's an acronym, actually, for Myofascial Energetic Lengthening Technique, M-E-L-T. It's about massaging and stretching the connective tissue. And, you know, that connective tissue is right underneath your skin. It's within your muscles, you know, the deep fascia, the superficial fascia. It's like as we get older, like those little aches and pains, you know, that you wake up with, right? Oh, yeah. And it's a whole rolling technique with the foam rollers and hitting reflexology points with soft balls. Mm-hmm. And so I studied that for a while. Mm-hmm. I'm a little odd that I like looking at like autopsy stuff and, you know.
I do too, so don't worry. We're in the same boat.
You know, I find anatomy fascinating. I truly do. So I did a lot of that. I used to teach a couple of classes of that. I incorporate some of that with my personal training.
By seeing how it all works.
And yeah, then, it's really interesting.
And then
stuff.
You also taught Pilates.
I did get Mat 1 and Mat 2 certified in classical Pilates. My last position was a general manager of Women's Only Fitness Boutique Studio, and we had a big Pilates component. And I think... Pilates is a wonderful format, as is yoga, as is strength, as is all these things. I mean, over the years, we've become, you know, first it was just your instructor, right? Mm. You know, you could teach almost anything. Now we become specialized. Yeah, you're a cycle instructor. You're a melt instructor. You're a Pilates instructor. The certifications have become, you know, rather expensive as well. I didn't do an in-depth study with the Pilates because, as with yoga, it's a practice and it's something that you really need to live. And I was just involved in a lot of different things, as you can see. I mean, the CPR work that I always did, which was in my 15 minutes of fame in 2010.
Well, I'm going to get to that.
Yeah.
But I do have to ask something about Pilates.
Yes.
Okay. I have people come in my practice all the time, mm-hmm. right? So they come sometimes right from the Pilates class. And what makes me laugh is they walk in. And, of course, this is like probably the over 50 crowd. Okay, let me explain that right there. And I know that's one of your specialties.
Yes.
So you're sitting there and they walk in and like who's walking lopsided, who's going, oh, my back. And I'll be like, where'd you come from? Because I could tell by the clothes. Like,
right.
I just came from Pilates. Then as we're doing all the stretching and doing everything, they're sitting there saying, I really hate doing Pilates, but it does my body good. Is it about Pilates that people just, they are prone to go to it? They are, it's like a ritual for them, but then complain after it's done. I have to know this.
the philosophy behind Pilates is that everything emanates from the core, which is true. And it's true of other modalities as well. I want to say they should have a better Pilates instructor because they shouldn't be coming in lopsided. The whole concept behind Pilates is that stretch and extension, and they should walk away feeling rejuvenated, really. It's very easy on the joints because it's all mat-based. If they do anything with apparatus, then you're coming into, like, the reformer is a really hot thing right now. To work on reformers and towers and things like that. It's actually really, really hard to do mat, because that's just your body.
Absolutely.
That's just your body. It's actually really tough, but you have to cue into that powerhouse. You have to cue into the core.
The core. Exactly.
Yeah, that's the whole name of the game. Yeah.
That's funny, because that's where I find the weaknesses in their core.
Well, that's why they're taking Pilates. They're trying to strengthen the core, you know?
They might be hurting other things. Yeah, maybe they're not doing it right to your thing. Now you specialize in the over 50 crowd, so you shift the focus from disease prevention to functional mobility.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, can you explain how you do that? Like, because we have a good listener base that's over 50.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. But at 50 is like the new 30, right? That's what
Absolutely.
We're saying. That's what I think.
You know, I'm over 50 myself. Absolutely. Look, you know, I'm a firm believer in there's always something you can do. You can start from today. You can start from tomorrow. But I love working with the complicated health histories. I mean, it's wonderful to have a nice, clean health history of somebody that's not on medication or didn't bust their knee during basketball or, you know, something along those lines. The weekend warrior, right? All of a sudden, and sometimes when you just hurt something, somebody has a car accident, right? I mean, it's life, right?
Absolutely.
And the body grows things as you get older, surgeries that you've had, childbirth. I mean, it all affects the body. So for me, I love working with people that have different things that they need to work around. Look, I love working with clean health histories. I mean, you know, it's just interesting. But personal training is personal. Mm. The person that comes and hires me, it's really you get to know that body and how it moves and how it has adjusted its gait, perhaps, you know, for something else that happened, you know, and what to do. I'm very well known by the medical community in my area. I'm from Westchester, New York, and I do get referred by, you know, from personal trainers, physical therapists, and because that, you know, you go to physical therapy, you hurt something, whatever it is, the doctor says go to physical therapy. The physical therapist works with that particular body part. And I love doing that bridge to get them back into a gym setting. Because otherwise, if they don't do that, then they're back to square one. They re-injure whatever they were doing.
Well, that's going to bring me to my point. Mm-hmm. Because, sorry to our listeners too, but I know several of them in this thing, is that after 50, a lot of times they hear, oh, I'm just too old to go to a gym. Or, no, I'm getting older. You know, this is going to hurt. That's going to hurt. And I'm a firm believer that if you take care of yourself, things are not going to be in discomfort all the time.
Absolutely.
You know? And to change that mindset, if somebody was to come to you and say, hey, I don't know if a gym is for me. Like, I know you're trying to help me and all. How do you work to motivate somebody? It's hard if they don't want to. I know they have to change. But how do you work with them to be able to change that mindset?
Well, then it becomes the life coaching and the behavior modification. You know, it became very evident to me. I would try to meet every new member that used to come to my studio. And you close the door. And, you know, at first it's like, I want to get in shape. And, you know, so it starts that way. I want to lose a few pounds. And then all of a sudden it's like everything else comes into play. You know, I've got the boomerang kids. I've got the aging parents. I work a lot. I'm tired. I put, you know, I hate the way I look in my body. You know, all these other elements come into play. So it's, you know, first it's like, okay, why are you here? Why did you hire me? Why are you here? You know, there's got to be a why. Why? What do you want to do? It's very hard when somebody says, my doctor told me, because you already, you know, somebody doesn't really want to be there.
Exactly. That's how they started too.
Right. There's no greater joy for me though, when I turn that person on, you know, and all of a sudden they become, you don't have to be, the basics are, you know, move as many days as possible. Try to stretch as many days as possible. Weight train every major muscle group twice a week. It's not a lot. And then try, and it's very important that we stretch, especially as we get older. I mean, that's just a fact of life. I myself only work out 4 to 5 times a week for no longer than 35, 40 minutes. So yeah, I see people, you know, they're at our facilities and they're working a couple hours. Good for you. You got that time. most of us are too busy. And, you know, so I try to help them figure it out. You know, first we say, okay, well, how many days do you think you're gonna be at my facility? And, or how many days you want to visit me? Oh, I'm going to be here every day. And I go, okay, that's not going to happen. You know, so, you know, you try to give, like, the reality check. So so it's really helping that person figure out what's best for them and how it's going to work. Is a home program going to work best? Is it to be around other people going to work best? I can tell you what the ideal is and what the basics should be. And then how can we fit that into your world? Because your world's different than the arts world. You know, it's, you know, everybody's different. And that's what I love about it.
Oh, yeah.
And I had started this program, mind, mouth, muscle. And that's the order, really. And, you know, everybody says that the New Year's resolution comes and everybody's, you know, go to the gym. And this is what you do. And every new show is about going to the gym. You have to change the behavior first.
Right.
Then you are what you eat. I'm sorry. You know, you have to eat healthy. The American diet is horrible. And then it's moving your body.
Well,
then
I like that. Mind, mouth, muscle. Good. How's that munchkin doing? Begins with an M.
She's making us feel guilty, all right?
Everyone I eat, I'm like 20 minutes on the treadmill. I'm like...
Oh, that's going to bring us to our next sponsor. And that is Neo Zoe Health and Wellness Center in Cranford, New Jersey. It's a very unique holistic wellness company recognizing the interconnection of body, mind, spirit, and the importance of creating complete wellness in a nurturing and comforting environment. Neo Zoe, creating new life through balanced living, using nutrition, massage, and so much more. And this month is March Massage Madness. So if you call for a massage, you will receive $10 off for every massage you get during this month. That is March Massage Madness. You can find them on the web at www.neozoe, that's N-E-O-S-Z-O-E.com, or call for an appointment today, 732-713-0123. That's Neo Zoe Health and Wellness Center in Cranford, New Jersey. As I say that, look at the look I am getting from Art.
Well, what's he doing?
I don't know. I'm getting those eyes because I probably picked on him first.
I'm sitting here thinking I can really use a massage right now.
I know. I can too. You want to give me one?
I'm not good, but I'll try. No.
You should go to get a massage.
Well, before you massage, you're going to be at the gym. So here's my next question for you, Kathy.
It's all part of self-care, too.
Is that, you know, somebody walks into a gym, okay, and they see...
This is like a joke, right? No.
They're not walking into a bar. Oh, okay. They're walking into a gym. Very good, Rich.
Two priests walk into a gym.
That's right. So that might be the joke. They're walking into the gym. And it's their first time there. Mm-hmm. And it could be very, very overwhelming.
Intimidating. You know,
and be like, this is not the equipment I was used to. I was used to like the stationary bike. Mm-hmm. You know, and now you see all the new and innovative equipment that mm-hmm. you have. So when somebody comes in, they might have fear, you know, of what to do. Do you walk them through to say, you know, what? First of all, you figure out what's best for them, mm-hmm. and then walk them through and show them how easy, and it really is easy to use?
Absolutely. I mean, the first thing is, it's always the first person that you meet. How are they going to greet you? My front desk people, that was like, you're the first impression and you're the last impression.
Absolutely.
You're the person that greets them and you're the person that says, have a good day. So they are almost the most important, and they're the lowest paid people on the totem pole, right? So, you know, they're very, very important. Then it's about... when I was a manager or even a trainer in a facility, when that was more my job, I bring them around and I just orient them. You know, every place usually has some form of orientation. If they do it well, they're introducing them to other members, other staff members. I mean, how does it feel like, you know, to say, hey, Maryann, how are you today? You know, oh, good to see you. It's your second day back, right?
Who's counting?
Right. And it's huge. Really, really trying to get into that person's head. Again, now this is the coaching piece of, you know, what is going to motivate you? Having a buddy? You know, is there someone you'd like to work out with? Is there somebody you can suggest that actually helps my business too, right? you know, or helping them. I do this weight loss program that I'm going to start up again in April. And basically it's the group dynamic. It's small group training.
Oh, okay.
You know, so they build that camaraderie, and all of a sudden if Sally doesn't show up, it's like, well, what happened to you today? You know, it's like
it's accountability.
You know, oh, total accountability. Yeah. That's why people hire trainers. Mm. You know, a lot of times, you know, when somebody comes to see me and says, I think I want to start, you know, with a trainer, and okay, well, you know, here's my recommendation. We start, you know, twice a week, and I orient you, and then, you know, we'll maybe, you know, slow down once a week. And sometimes people just like having that because we change the goals as we go along, depending on, you know, what they're doing. So it's about the entire staff or who's ever there making them feel welcome, you know. And if they feel welcome, and making them feel accomplished, that always was huge to me.
Right.
You know, I've had my oldest client is 85 years old, and I just say, just don't stop moving. That's the big thing. She's been training with me like 13 years, and sure, 13 years ago was a little different, and she was in her 70s at that point, right? But now we work on a lot more balance and stability and, you know, of course, strength.
Right.
Because, you know, that eighth decade, we really start to decline physically. It's just fact. You know, so it's something that always making them feel, okay, you couldn't, but look what you can do. Mm. There's always something they can do. And then they walk away feeling euphoric and wanting to do that. They feel so good. It's all about that sense of well-being as well. You know, not only, I've had people come to me, I just want to lift my laundry basket. I'm like, really? Mm. You know, I mean, it's like, but that's their goal.
Yeah.
That's their goal. And that's okay. That's okay.
No, they're there. They want to get help, which is great. Because you're never too old to exercise.
Never. Mm. You can see some form of benefit at any age.
Absolutely.
Mm. Any age.
It keeps you young.
Absolutely does.
I was intimidated going to the gym.
I knew that was coming. You see me look right over at him. I knew it was coming.
Well, because it was like all young guys. You know what I mean? Like when you went in there, you felt like you had to compete with them, you know?
Nah.
That's why I went in the morning with the old, with the people in their 80s. I felt young.
Did you feel young? And did you show them?
But I didn't feel like I had to compete with them. You know what I mean?
And just think, you made them feel like they had to compete with you.
You know, they didn't have much to compete.
You know, a lot of people, when they come in, they think that everybody... I just had this question online. Somebody asked me, you know, I'm embarrassed to go back. I put on a few pounds. People are going to look at me. If you go early morning, nobody's looking at you. No. The early morning people are like this. They come in, they're on a mission. They don't even want to say good morning. You know, it's like, you know, it's like they're on a mission. They got to get it done because they got to get off. It's a very... typical type of personality. Mm. The midday crowd is more like, oh, the social people, kind of, you know, they have a little more time to spare.
Well, anybody who's available at 10 o'clock in the morning has time to spare.
That's right. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. So, I mean, really, it's nobody, and I even responded to this woman. She was, a young woman, actually. She was like 40. That's young to me now. And, you know, basically I was like, if you don't feel welcome there, oh, my God, the options that are out there for you, go to another gym.
Right. But also, too, I think people are so concerned. Like, let's face it, in your 20s, you know, you want to feel sexy. You want to have that great body, male or female. You're concentrating on it. Your 30s, possibly, too. Mm-hmm. By the time you get to 40, you're starting to get wisdom with you as well. And your schedule's crazy and all that stuff. So you let a little thing, you know, go.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think as you get older, you get the wisdom to be comfortable in your own skin. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, absolutely. So like, to that woman, sense of self. Yeah.
Right, better sense. Exactly. And I feel like that woman that you're saying, like she's in her 40s, like to say, just go to the gym. Who cares what people think about you? You care what you think about yourself. That's all that matters.
Well, that's an exercise within itself, right?
Absolutely.
You know, so.
Yeah, so. Right. It's like absolutely. Yes, yeah, I know. No, seriously, the last thing I said to this woman was, if you don't feel welcome there, go to another place. Oh, my word. I mean, there are so many options out there. And
speaking
of
that, you're currently an account management consultant for Gym Wisely.
Yes.
Which is a marketplace for fitness club memberships. Can you tell us a little bit about that? That you're mentioning that somebody could go someplace else?
Yes. We just, I was approached by the founder in the fall, and right after, you know, my studio had closed, while I was looking to see, well, what am I going to do, you know, and you know, in this industry that I love. We just started it a couple weeks ago. We just had to get all the background stuff. Basically, Gym Wisely, and that's all one word, is a membership-based vehicle for studios and gyms to hit a different stream of revenue of people that are looking for variety in their workouts. And when I started 30 some odd years ago, you might have a studio and a gym, and you might work at both places, maybe work at one. Now you have all these studios, and they all have specialties, and all these gyms, and you have the big box gyms, and you got the lower end gyms, and the Y's, and you have everything. And this enables, right now we're onboarding studios and gyms. That's our first wave to join us, and the member will be able to take partial memberships. So because a lot of people can't afford to buy two full memberships, but they like to do the, you know, in the intense cardio at this one place, but they want to do Pilates over here. You know, so the member of Gym Wisely picks a primary gym, and then according to what partners we have on board, they're able to buy partial memberships.
Great idea.
That yeah, it totally is, and it is a definite win-win. It's free to the gyms and the studios to join us. It's a free platform for them, and we advertise them and market them. And it's recurring membership.
Know why I like that?
Why?
Because if one day I like the crowd at this gym, I could go there. If I mm-hmm. like the people at this gym on this day, I could go there.
That's
so
exactly
it's giving
right.
me options, wow. which would keep me motivated.
That's exactly right. So basically, the member of Gym Wisely is able to change that configuration. It's done in increments of 5, so 5, 10, 15, 20. And at certain junctures in their membership with Gym Wisely, they're able to change that depending mm-hmm. on who is. But the win-win for the studios and the gyms that are joining us that, you know, see this vision, first of all, they can sell them on any of the ancillary products that they have, whether it be personal training, swimming, tennis lessons, retail, anything, smoothies, coffee, you know, and, right. and everybody has something different. And we don't have any part of that. But they will get that recurring monthly, you know, membership.
Oh.
So it's really a cool concept.
Yeah,
I definitely think it's the way of the future, that we're all going to stay, you know, in business. When I was the general manager of the health club, the studio that I was running, it was a women's only studio. We had a huge Pilates component.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, you know, it would happen. People would say, my family wants to join this membership. I can't afford to carry two full memberships. Okay. If I could have offered that, hey, we're partners with so-and-so, yeah. and not lose my hundred and some odd dollars
right.
and get 50 or, you know, 70, you know, it would have been a nice way to, you know, hold on
yep.
For that recurring membership,
right.
Recurring revenue.
Mm. And by the way, you're saying Gym Wisely, it's GYM, like you're going to the gym.
Yes. It's so funny. What my girlfriend says to me, she goes, I thought his name was Jim Wisely. You know, it's like who your boss is. And I was like, no, it's Jim Wisely.
Well, that's why I'm saying it, because it sounds
right.
like a name and I
right.
see the spelling, but it's Jim,
right.
like you're going to the gym.
Right, Jim Wisely. And right now, we literally just started the last few weeks. And we have, you know, a lot of studios and gyms that are onboarding with us as partners.
Yeah,
yeah.
Great idea.
Absolutely.
So now the gyms and the studios become my clients, if
yeah.
you want to say.
Yeah.
So I'm their account manager.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That really
yeah.
is. And with that good thing, we have another good thing to talk about. Are you a family member that has somebody with addiction? Are you the person with addiction? City of Angels is conquering our addictions. And if you or a loved one is struggling with addiction, help is available 24 hours a day. You can call 609-910-4942. And City of Angels is such a wonderful organization. They work strictly on donations, and your donations are used for every sense of the word help of whatever you need. And if you'd like to make a donation, you could visit them at the web at www.cityofangelsnj.org. And while you're there, when you click on the donations tab, you can enter any denomination you like. And in the special instructions, if you put donation for the Health and Wellness Show, we will make you an official sponsor for the show for 30 days. So please help a loved one, help somebody else, or if you've recovered and been a member of City Angels or not and want to help, you can give back by making that donation. So again, City of Angels, you can call them at 609-910-4942 or visit them on the web at cityofangelsnj.org. So talk about life-saving. I know something else about you. You are an American Red Cross and American Heart Association certified CPR and AED instructor.
Mm-hmm.
And after all, it's a good thing that you know CPR, being a professional trainer, especially around people like us.
Mm-hmm.
It's good that you know this, okay? So you've had to use CPR on someone in an incident at the Mount Kisco Athletic Club.
Yes.
Can you share that story in detail? Because I found it fascinating.
Oh, my 15 minutes of fame, right? Really a proud moment for me, actually, and my staff at the time. I was the fitness director at this Upper Westchester club, and it was July 15th of 2010. You don't forget those things.
Mm.
And it was 9:30 in the morning, which is a busy time, you know, at the club. And I had received, somebody started shouting that somebody fell off the treadmill. Now that happens, right? We've seen it all, yeah, a couple, it's funny, but not funny, right? And the first thing that I did was grab the first aid kit, you know, because what happens is people don't use the emergency stops. How many of you people are guilty? Never put it on, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And what happens is the belt keeps going and, you know, that's how they get hurt really, besides falling off. And I go running with the first aid kit, and it was in the back. The treadmills were in the back of the studio of the club. It was a 13,000 square foot facility, and I go running back there, and it was quite obvious that the gentleman was blue. Mm-hmm. And then I went running back to grab the AED because it was in the front of the club, and started yelling, you know, 911, call 911, you know, cardiac arrest, and you know, yelling so that you know. I became a CPR instructor back in 2000. I've always been certified because every industry I've been in, I've had to be certified. Mm-hmm. And I just think it's an important skill set to know anyway.
Right.
And I became instructor certified back in like 2006 or so because I just found that that sometimes, especially fitness people would let it lapse until the boss said, you got to get your certification current. And I also felt we didn't have an emergency plan if something happened. So I wanted to be able to certify my staff. And basically, you know, everybody fell into line. I brought the AED. You know, one of my master trainers was already shaking this gentleman. And basically we lifted his t-shirt, I slapped the AED on and I shocked him once and we began the cycle of, 30 compressions and two breaths working, two rescuers to, the one victim. Wow. And I was so proud because literally it was like clockwork. I've never had been called. I've called a code before cause I did work with cancer patients, mm-hmm. but that's in a hospital setting,
right?
And, you know, and it's so important who that first person is that gets to that victim.
Absolutely.
One of my trainers went to the door to show the EMS where we were, because we were all the way in the back, you know. Somebody else was taking down the health history with so-and-so. Do you know this gentleman? It's such an interesting, surreal moment because people don't know what to do. There's people that keep exercising. It's like pretty wild. People run to the bathroom. That's that's always my favorite. Yeah. And or other people like, do we know who it is? Right. That's the other thing too. And we did about three cycles or so. And then all of a sudden I saw signs of life and I said, you know, stop, you know, let's check. But that's where, you know, like EMS was there and they said, you know, good job. We brought back his pulse. We brought back his breath. Wow. He was unconscious. All I kept thinking when I was doing, I was the one doing the compressions and my my trainer was doing the breaths, was after I shocked him. And the moral of the story there is if the AED is there, use it. You know, when I teach it, it's like, okay, begin compressions.
Yes, exactly.
You know, there's a whole order of doing it. But if it's there and I brought it, use it.
Yeah, yeah.
And basically, you know, it was almost like when I teach now the course, and this is several years later now, I still defer back to that that save because it was so classic. And all I kept thinking of, I'm pounding and I'm going, faster, Kath, faster, like that.
It's exhausting.
How come I'm not breaking any ribs? That's all I kept thinking. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Why are there no ribs breaking? And what we found out after the fact was even though he was a 63-year-old gentleman, he was actually a martial artist. So his bones were dense, right?
Oh.
More you exercise earlier on, you're going to have more dense bones, you know, right? That's just kind of, you know, for bone density, osteoporosis, you could go on and on about that kind of stuff. But yeah, he was taken out of there. I mean, he had a triple bypass the next day. Within a week, he was doing cardiac rehab. And
amazing.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
I mean, for every minute you delay CPR or that AED, automatic external defibrillator, because you know, people ask me what that means, right? That prognosis keeps going down.
It does, but you guys got him to the hospital. He had a double bypass, was
triple,
it? Oh, it was triple bypass.
Yeah, triple bypass.
And he survived.
He's in my club.
And you know what's wonderful? In that time and space that you're saying this person was taking, you know, telling people where to go, this person was taking the health history.
That as a team.
What people don't realize, that is the quickest 5 minutes you've ever heard of something like that because you have to respond instantly. So what you're saying, it's not like leisurely, like this one's going here, this one's going there. It happens so fast and people have to respond quickly that to have a team in place, I commend you for that.
Yeah, wow.
Because for everybody to have something to know what to do right then and there to get that gentleman the help that he needed, you doing the first signs of life, if you will, and to be able to bring them back, and then, you know, the rescue squads come in and do their thing, and the surgeons do their thing, you saved a life. That's huge.
It's huge.
You'll never forget it as long as you live.
You just don't.
But to the adrenaline that's in there when you're trying to help somebody like that.
But the knowledge kicked in.
It does. And it's so interesting because the internal dialogue was like, oh, like he was gasping, which is not breathing. That, you know, you teach that. I go, just as I teach it. Yeah, that was like, you know, so interesting. Yeah. But, you know, the next day I was like, oh, you know, I didn't do upper body. Why do my forearms hurt?
Oh, those compressions take a lot out of you.
Pounding. And basically it was great. It was a busy time of the day, and I did have a lot of trainers there. So everybody everybody just fell into line. Like nobody had, you're the guy that gets the, you know, it just fell into line. And you know, it was, but what I also teach is, because the longer I do this, when I teach my CPR course, whether it be for healthcare providers or the layman or, you know, trainers, it's, and there's different levels depending on who you are. You know, it's so interesting because I'm just like, okay, if you're there alone, you have to do something. And the stories that I hear and the stories that I use in teaching my courses are all real. Mm. They're all real. I mean, somebody did find somebody at the ATM, you know, they opened the door to get money and somebody's on the floor. Somebody was in a choking situation, a loved one at, Easter, you know, so it's, and usually when you're called into action, it's someone you know. It's someone you know.
I'll tell you that right there. This guy has 9 lives. We have a caller on the phone, and welcome to the Health and Wellness Show. This is your host, Maryann, with our special guest, Kathy Margiasso. No, Margiasso?
Margiasso, good.
I got it. Oh, my God. I actually got that.
Very good.
And who is this? You're live on the air.
Hi, it's Lee calling. I just wanted to ask Kathy, what does she think is the best fitness plan for women over 50?
Kathy. My goodness. Here we go. That's very vague, really.
Really talking about muscle, bone health, you know, women over 50, you trip and fall, you really hurt yourself. So I'm kind of wondering, what are your recommendations?
Okay. The first thing is to want to do it. So, so what are we going to do? Find a place where, you know, usually it's within a radius of where you work or where you live, you know, to make it convenient for you to do it. Are you going to work out in the morning? Are you going to work out in the afternoon? When are you going to work out? There's 24 hours in a day. And some wise man said to me one time, you have 48 opportunities. I go, well, 48. It really only takes half an hour. So when you really break it down to somebody, it's only half an hour, you know? So when they go, oh, I think I can find half an hour, you know, to do that. For women in particular, over 50, most women don't lift heavy enough. It's so interesting to see women in class with 2 and 3 pound weights and they're swinging them all over the place. And then they take a 20 pound pocketbook and walk out of the room. Right. So it's like, they fling it over their shoulder and they walk out of the room. We lift babies heavier than that. Right. I had 10 pound kids. It was like, oh, you know, so it's, they don't, you know, learn to, the basics are, again, to move as many days of the week as possible, to stretch as many days of the week as possible, to strength train twice a week, all the major muscle groups, and then to eat clean as best as you can. And I'm a firm believer that life is about living. You know, meaning like, I don't believe in, you know, not having the family dinner and things like that. Mm. That's about connection, right?
Right.
And our holidays and things mm-hmm. like that. So you have to create a relationship with food. So it's really the whole picture. As for our bones, as women, we need a checkup, a full health history should be taken by whoever works with you so that they can really work a program around your body. But the first thing is to just do it. Make the decision that that's what you want to do. And there's so many options.
But how do you motivate yourself, Kathy? I mean, personally, me, I just don't have the motivation to do this kind of thing. I'd rather, like, you know, people say I have a couple eggs in the morning. I'd rather have them eat two Cadbury eggs in the morning. So, like, how do you actually motivate yourself?
Okay. Well, you know, it's small changes. It's small changes. It's for someone who is making this lifestyle change, it's overwhelming. The whole picture is overwhelming. So let's make the small changes. So first, do you drink any water? You'd be shocked how many people drink no water at all or have a hard time. 64 ounces is what's recommended per day, at least. Second thing is let's try. What I usually try to do with new clients is break it down for them. What do you do Monday? What do you do Tuesday? Mm-hmm. What do you do Wednesday? What time do you get up in the morning? Do you get enough sleep? You know, that's a huge thing. What do you actually eat? What do you eat at 8 a.m.? What do you eat at 10? What do you eat at 12? You know, really trying to make those small changes. And how does it fit in your world? Because how it's going to fit in your world is not the way it's going to fit in my world. So that's the first thing. And you have to want it. And what's your why? It's about your why. You know, why do you want to make this change? If you're happy the way it is, so be it. All right. You know? So does that answer your question?
Well, kind of, but what do you do about sugar cravings?
Sugar cravings.
Hard one.
That absolutely takes some time. And if we make some of these small changes and you know, the cravings will go down, you know, carbohydrate changes, you know, if we just make some of these small changes, and then you'll find that after the first 3-4 days is tough, and then the cravings start to go away. Find a program that works for you. There's plenty out there. And basically, what happens with people that have a problem with sugar and sugar cravings is they open the bag of M&Ms and they eat the whole bag. And then it becomes a downward spiral, you know? Because now it's the guilt and everything else. Well, you know what? Did you enjoy it? Was it good? You know, it's like, okay, move on. Today's a new day. Every day is another is an opportunity to make a healthy choice.
Oh, that's good.
Every single day.
Yeah, and don't beat yourself up.
So you would recommend the small bag of the Cadbury Mini Eggs at Easter time?
We have something else to motivate you, Lee. We have something else that can motivate you.
Yes.
We do.
Totally the worst. I am the worst.
But do you exercise, Lee?
I do.
Okay, good, because now we have something that might motivate you. And this is a complimentary set of glow buds from High Tech that you can have, that you could actually, you know, put to some music. And, you know, as you're eating that Cadbury egg, as it has one color, you could be looking at the color of your glow bud wires to keep you moving.
These things are great. Tell her what they are.
Yeah, the glow buds are neon glowing sport earphones that we talked about earlier in the show, and they're absolutely
great,
phenomenal.
Great.
And just for calling in and asking these direct questions and admitting your guilt, your guilty pleasures, we are going to give you one of these as a special prize.
Is there really anything better than, like, besides Halloween, because that's the perfect holiday for me? I mean, who can go door to door and get free candy? But Easter candy is like the best thing in the world.
Absolutely.
I'm sorry. I am totally there. So I love a good Easter bunny, and I love a Cadbury Mini.
Do you eat the ears first or the butt?
I go with the butt because I shrink it down until I've got nothing but a head. I try to pretend that I really didn't need it. I'm sad.
I love it, Lee.
Yes, I am that person, and I've been that person since about 5 years old. I would always start with a tail and the butt and just shrink that bunny down till I had a head and some ears. That way it didn't look so bad.
I eat the ears, and then the bunny's going, what? What? What'd you say? I didn't hear you. What?
I've got to make it look good.
Well, I absolutely love it. And for that, Lee, we're going to send you the Glow Buds. And what we would need you to do is send us an email with your mailing information so we could email
this
out.
Thank you very much. And those small changes I'll try to make. I'm doing it today. It was a gorgeous day, so I was out walking. I did 2.5 miles.
Perfect.
It's good with the weather being nicer. But, you know, when you go to Target and you're just going to Target for, like, laundry detergent, somehow that Easter department gets you.
Oh, I'm sure it does.
Lisa gets me.
You're not the only one.
I'm going to have this Dunkin' Munchkin in her honor.
Absolutely.
There you go.
Well, thank you so much, Lee, for calling the show. And you can email me at Maryann@neozoe.com with your mailing information, and we would love to send you your set of Glow Buds.
Well, thank you so much. What a great radio show, and thank you.
Thank you so much, Lee.
I'm gonna take try to take the small steps.
Absolutely.
I can only take the small ones.
Perfect. Slow and steady wins the race. Remember that.
Exactly.
You don't make the dash like you do to your chocolate. You go slow and steady exercising.
That's right.
Exactly. Thank you so much.
All right, good luck.
And have a great evening.
You too.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Well, that's going to bring us to our next sponsor, because as we're talking about the Glow Buds from High Tech, they're about music. And our next sponsor is Rich Chlanda and Flying Dreams. It is a progressive rock band featuring world-renowned musicians Rich Chlanda from Fire Ballet, Nectar, Renaissance, and his own project Flying Dreams. Ron Beanstalk, who used to play with the Suits and all under members that you would see. Kendall Scott, who is also a Project Object, and many other bands, and now also with Nectar, and from Frank Zappa and many other bands that you see, Jay Didymo. If you want to find out where they're playing next, and the show is absolutely incredible that they just had at the Cutting Room, you can follow them on the web at www.richchlanda, that's RycheChlanda, flyingdreams.com. Thank you, Rich, for being a sponsor of the Health and Wellness
You're
Show.
You're very welcome.
And with that, I do want to talk about something of events for this weekend for City of Angels. They have a brand new training institute called City of Angels Training Institute. And this Saturday, March 23rd, and Sunday, March 24th, it's the Recovery Coach and Professionalism Training, which both Richie and I will be attending so we could finish up our certification to become Recovery Coach Professionals.
I'm coming now.
And on April 7th through April 13th is the CCAR Recovery Coach Academy through City of Angels Training Institute. All classes are held at the First Baptist Church of Hightstown, New Jersey. The course prices are on the site as well, and they're offering inaugural prices. We're putting in a promo code of RCP intro at checkout. We'll get you a nice discount. And in an effort to make the Recovery Coach Professional designation affordable to everyone, Cody does offer an installment plan where you could pay $199.75 a month for over 4 months. For course information and to be able to help change somebody's life, you can visit the City of Angels Training Institute on the web at www.cody, that's CoatiNJ.com. So now with that, before we get into life coaching and all, we like to have feeling peaceful, and music heals very well, right? Mm-hmm. Oh. So are we all game? Art, are you game?
Sure.
Good. Mark behind me, are you game?
I'll go for it.
All right. And Kathy?
Sure.
Okay. So all you listeners at home, it is time for our health and wellness sing-along. Something by the Eagles. Peaceful, easy feeling. Here's our very own Rich Chlanda.
I love the way your sparkling earrings lay against your skin so brown. And I want to sleep with you in the desert night,
with a billion stars all around. And I got a peaceful, easy feeling. And I know you won't let me down, 'cause I'm already standing on the ground. And I found out a long time ago what a woman can do to your soul. Ah, but she can't take you anyway. You already know how to go. And I got a peaceful, easy feeling, and I know you won't let me down, 'cause I'm already standing on the ground. I get this feeling I may know you as a lover and as a friend, but this voice keeps whispering in my other ear, tells me I may never see you again. 'Cause I got a peaceful, easy feeling, and I know you won't let me down, 'cause I'm already standing.
Well, baby, I'm already standing. Well, baby, I'm
Rich, come on, everybody, nice and loud, and for you at home.
'Cause I got a peaceful, easy feeling, and I know you won't let me down, 'cause I'm
everybody.
Wow, you did great.
I'm very proud of you for not stopping in the middle.
So am I. And you know what? I'm just going to say it again.
Thank you.
We have another official sponsor, and they can listen to Peaceful Easy Feeling through their high-tech low buds.
George?
Yes. They're safety and sound, high-performance audio for outdoor joggers, bicycling, and all sports. High-tech brand of earphones are designed and manufactured with electroluminescence technology. Glowbud earphones emit a safe and bright neon light that with the touch of a button will flicker neon lighting along to your favorite tunes. In addition, for enhanced audio experience, they added in high-performance studio drivers designed to their specifications for churning out amazingly clear and vibrant highs and bottom to create one of the best sport earphones for indoor and outdoor use, day or night, on the market today. Now you can feel safe at night with enhanced visibility for walking and talking, jogging, and being seen by street traffic wearing their Sports Talk Glow Buds. Hear and see the difference. You can get your pair today through their distributor at www.whatsonsale.com. That's WATTSONSALE.com. Get your pair today. Thank you for being a sponsor here on the Health and Wellness Show. Thank you, Richie.
You're welcome.
And
they look great, those things. They look great. Hold those up. Again.
I love them. And they're cool, and they glow. And I just like the beating lights too. I did. I really love them. This would keep me motivated, actually, because this would mesmerize me. It really would. I absolutely love it.
Yeah, that's
and
great.
To motivate people, I think they should get a pair. Mm-hmm. I really think that. So thank you for your sing-along, and thank you for singing.
Yeah, pretty good.
Not everybody likes to.
She does it all.
I heard it all. She does. Wow.
My daughter is a singer and a musician, and I said, could I just be there? Shut off my mic. I can be in the back.
You did great.
Well.
And thank you, Mark.
You are a life coach.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
And for listeners who do not know what a life coach does, because they might get a little like, oh, my God, she's going to tell me what I can't do. Mm-hmm. Can you explain what one can expect from a life coach?
A life coach is very different than any other relationship that you have, very different than like a sports coach or anything along those lines. What we do is we assist you and we help you find the greatness within yourself. Mm. So someone comes with a want or a need. They have a goal. And we say, okay, well, you know, let's kind of make it a game, because game indicates fun, right?
Absolutely.
You know, work is not fun.
No,
right?
It's not.
So basically it's okay. So how are we going to play this game? You know, what can we make it a winnable game? I mean, is it something you can win at? A true coach, a life coach will not tell the client what to do. I help you figure out what the actions you should take that week and to, you know, to achieve that goal. We assess, you know, the actions that you've done and you know, or inaction is good too. It's like, because then it's like, well, why didn't you do what you said you were going to do?
Exactly.
Right. Holds you accountable. And sometimes when I'm working with a client, they realize that what they initially set out to do is not what they really want, but it has to come from the client. It has to come from the client. You know, they initially say it could be something as simple as, I really think I want to change careers. You know, I want to do something different. And you help them explore that. And it's by asking direct questions from me, listening actively, you know, to what they have to say, feeling those energy shifts as they respond, and letting them have that that moment where they realize this is what I want. And it's really important. Is that game? Is it an achievable goal? Is it winnable? Do you need to learn new skill sets to do this, or whatever it is? It could be something as simple as we had I had a client one time that didn't know how to tell their aging mother about something. You know, it could be something as simple as that. You know, what steps? So that's really what a life coach is. It's about any issue that's really bugging them. We move from today forward. Therapy is we're looking at your past, right? I'm not a therapist. You know, so if all of a sudden things come up that we unearth things that are really troubling, I refer them out. Because obviously I'm not qualified for that. But we move from today forward, and it's about that the imperfect is perfect. You know, if somebody who's maybe disorganized but is very creative, well, that's great, right? I mean, you know, it's like, you know, so, you know, it's about helping that client realize that they had it in themselves all along to achieve whatever it is. It's just being a champion for them. That's really what a life coach does.
It's teaching them how to believe in themselves.
Absolutely.
That's my personal opinion. That's what I see a lot.
Where we work side by side in a non-judgmental environment, in a confidential environment, that they're, you know, they're able to express. And it's just a very unique relationship.
And it's got to be rewarding for you that when you see that person came to you for help and then you help them attain their goal, it has to be rewarding for you.
Oh, it absolutely is. It absolutely is. It really is very gratifying. You know, just and again, I did the whole life coaching certification coursework because I just felt that when people would come and say, I got to get in shape, remember, it's back to that behavior modification, right? And, it, you know, it's like, well, what's in your way? What is that What is mm-hmm. in your way? Is it fear? I mean, we talk about all those things. Mm. What would you do? I used to often say to my kids, and when they had a decision to make, what would you do if fear was not a factor? Mm. What would you do if fear was, and is it a realistic fear? Whatever it is that you want to do. So, I mean, it's all these questions, and it's some people go, oh, well, I would do this. Okay, so, you know, right? So that's really what life coaching is, and it's very rewarding, and especially in my industry, again, it was really getting into their heads and helping them change that behavior. It could be as simple as, I want to lose 10 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
What's your sticking point? You know, what is it? And that's really
for our last caller,
that.
It was Cadbury eggs. That was the sticking point.
That was her sticking point, yes.
Any of this sound familiar to you, Maryann?
Yes, a lot of it
I know, I know. And then that kind of rolled over into the health coaching and the Optavia that I started doing. It was very interesting. Last fall, I started... I used to run these weight loss programs, and, you know, a weight loss program, it had a beginning, it had an end, right? Mm. So they do great while they were on the program, and then all of a sudden they go back to all the same habits, you know. So, you know, so what happened, you know, what happened there? And I started, you know, I am older. I'm going to be 57.
Yay.
Okay, next month. Okay.
Wow, and, you're the only one cheering.
And, you know, baby. And you start to say, well, okay, you know, most of my clientele is, you know, our bodies are changing, and, you know, they're a little older, whether it be male or female, you know, those of us that have had children and, you know, things like that, you know, and you go to the doctor and they go, well, everything looks good, but your BMI is not that good, right? You know, but they don't tell you how to get there.
Body mass index.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, very good. That's exactly what it is.
Nobody knows what that is.
And, you know, and even myself, I was like, even when I train somebody, I will not do an exercise on a client unless I've tried it myself. Mm-hmm. Okay. I won't do something unless I've tried it. So I was sampling different programs, and I came across Optavia. One of my clients had actually said, did you have a look into this? What I love about the program, and then I became a coach for them, was that, again, it's teaching people the habits of health. You know, there's four components. It's the habits of health. It's that you have a coach that coaches you through this process, different than a life coach, because a coach really shouldn't be telling you what to do. I'm obviously, you know, you know, holding their hand and, you know, telling them what to do. It's about the fuelings, learning to treat food as a fueling, you know, rather than, ooh, that tastes good, right? And it's about a community, because it's a private Facebook group, and, you know, everybody supports each other, and they can be as involved as they want or uninvolved. But it's really a solid program, because it just starts with, you know, let's change one habit at a time. And people actually, it's a, you know, high protein, low carb, you know, type of program, and people really start to lose weight. Wow. And it really opened the door for me to, you know, some people that really have a lot of weight to lose. Mm. You know, it's kind of, you know, looking at the United States, you know, just in general, the population, I mean, 71% of the adult population is either, or, you know, overweight or obese. So, you know, comes with a lot of, you know, health factors. So it's about creating healthy habits. And I just thought the program was very sound and very, you know, orients you to how can you continue those good habits. And that's what I love about the program.
Well, that's great.
Yeah.
And everybody can change their eating habits.
Everybody can. You have it within yourself. You had it there all along.
Yeah. And it doesn't mean you have to deprive yourself. It's just everything in moderation.
Actually,
I mean,
it was amazing to me to just stop, like, sugar water, teas, sodas. You know what I mean? Things that had sugar in them. I lost a lot of weight.
When you had your scare, and you stopped. You changed your diet.
I drink a lot more water now.
Sometimes just those little things, you know, they add up. And you know, a pound or two, it makes a difference. It makes a difference.
Oh, yeah.
You know, just 10% of your body weight makes a huge health improvement.
Absolutely.
You know, so,
and if you don't think so, go get yourself some free weights of the weight that you lost. So say you lost 10 pounds, tie 10 pounds around your waist and start walking around again. And
I lost 15 pounds just not drinking soda.
There you go. Absolutely. That would happen. Yeah. It's really good. And speaking of that, if you have some type of addiction, yours is sugar, there is our next sponsor is the Recovery Spot. Innovating recovery with cutting-edge addiction treatment and outpatient recovery for drugs and alcohol, offering state-of-the-art medical approaches combined with personal treatment. They are physicians-owned and operated by physicians Dr. Ramesh Sawhney and Dr. Scott Bienenfeld. The Recovery Spot is innovating recovery. Not only are they in New York, where you could visit them on the web at www.recoveryspotny.com, but they are now open on the West Coast in Malibu and San Diego, California. And you can visit them on the web there in California at www.recoveryspotca.com. And if you want to contact any of the facilities, you can do so at 866-677-6869. The Recovery Spot, where they're innovating recovery. So there's hope for all of us for addiction. It doesn't matter if it's
what it is, right?
Soda, mm-hmm. Cadbury eggs, M&Ms, because he was having M&Ms earlier, so I think that's pretty funny. Yes. You know, just gave you up.
You know, well, look, you know.
We're Cadbury eggs.
I think I saw some in there. I saw some Cadbury
might
eggs.
Be, they might be old, though. That might be last Easter.
Yeah, well, you know.
Well, speaking of that, and Malibu. Getting fit with Kathy over here, you could save the date. Yes, I said save the date for Friday, November 8th, 2019. City of Angels is having its 10th anniversary gala at the Mercer Oaks. It's at 725 Village Road West, West Windsor Township, New Jersey. And to keep up with all the latest details for this event, you can visit their website at www.cityofangelsnj.org. So we'll all be in shape for that gala.
We also have our date for the run this year. It's September 14th.
September 14th.
No Rockfest.
No Rockfest, right?
No, I'm taking a break this year.
Yeah. Well,
that was a great event last year, by the way.
I'm figuring when you come back from your world tour, we'll end at the Cure Arena in Trenton.
Yeah.
That's funny.
It's not funny. I'm working on that.
Well.
Yeah, you know, well. Absolutely. You know what I'm thinking about, Maryann? I'm thinking about San Diego. Where are those two recovery spots?
Malibu and San Diego.
That's and where that's where
Dr. Sawhney.
San Diego is more your type, man.
Yeah. So, well, Dr. Sawhney was at the cutting room. He was at the cutting room with his beautiful wife Nina and stuff, and that's the gentleman that you know that we we're friends with.
I will serve
and
you coffee with cream. Da, da, da. I want to go to Malibu. Da, da, da.
You singing to him?
Yes, I am. Dr. Ramesh Sawhney. I hope he hears me. Yeah, I'm trying to serenade him. Sublink.
Well, maybe we'll go
subliminally.
Maybe we'll go there and teach him guitar or like.
I was trying.
Doc, can I live in your garage?
Well, speaking of getting around, you're also a professional speaker too, Kathy.
Wow.
And I'm assuming that you do it with your life coaching and things like
that. It depends. It depends what somebody, you know, wants me to come speak about, you know. So, you know, some motivational speaking, you know.
Do you have any engagements coming up soon or you're still booking things?
I'm still booking things. I don't have anything, you know, coming up currently, but yeah. So.
And anybody who listens to the show mm-hmm. tonight that wants to look and speak to you about professional training, fitness, health coaching, life coaching, CPR classes that you give, how can they contact you?
Well, they can contact me either on Facebook, just at Kathy Margiasso, M-A-R-G-I-A-S-S-O. So they can private message me there. They can also email me at kathy.margiasso@gmail.com, or my business phone is 914-224-3612.
I'm checking off my checklist. I actually had all. I can't believe I have that right.
There you go.
Yay. See?
You did good.
I did good. I'm very proud of that.
Yeah.
You have been a wonderful, fabulous guest.
I love tonight's show.
I mean, you've really been very informative. And I really enjoyed you. You were really good.
It's good, right?
So good information. It was great.
Yeah, and Mark Biner, thank you so much for the recommendation.
It's my pleasure.
You've come through, my friend. And for the Glow Buds by High Tech, I'm going to keep saying this because I love these. I'm actually in love with these.
Everyone in the studio gets a pair.
There you go.
See that? I love his marketing.
Yeah, it's kind of like Oprah, and you get one, and you get one.
And you get one, right?
Absolutely.
Thanks, Art.
I'm waiting for the car. No.
Yes, and we will have our next show Wednesday, April 17th at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and stay tuned because we have a bunch of all-new guests coming up over the next couple months here on the Health and Wellness Show on COARadio.com. Rich, thank you so much for being part of the show.
You're welcome.
And I appreciate you playing and doing everything that
I
you do.
I had a great time. We had fun.
I did. Did you learn anything from Kathy tonight?
Yeah, a lot. You know, and just how she is, the whole thing very motivational. You know, just I could see how you really get your clients going.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You. It's really the truth.
Well, you're into health and fitness yourself, so you relate to this. This was a show that you can relate to.
I know. Well, health and when you're on the stage, I mean, you have to be healthy. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's no drug, there's
endurance.
Nothing that beats health.
That's mm-hmm. true.
Right.
Yeah, you know, so.
If you don't have you healthy, you don't have anything.
Yeah,
that's
really, true. Well, so thank you for doing what you do.
Thank you.
And your story was great because it's true that everything in your life that you did, you incorporated in what you do, mm-hmm. and it's wonderful. So thank you.
She made it easy.
And made it easy, yeah, great.
Art, I want to thank you every month for every show, actually, on COARadio.com. You help all of us through. You are the man.
It's always a pleasure.
All of it.
Yeah,
and we couldn't make it work without you. So thank you so much for what you do, not only for this radio station, but for the City of Angels organization.
Thanks for putting up with me.
You put up with us. That's what I definitely know. And until next time, I am your host, Maryann Castello of the Health and Wellness Show on COARadio.com. Until next time, good night, everybody.